One of the consequences of Moore's law and the performance improvements that we expect to follow is the so-called memory wall. Here's why we have it. The processor speed, in terms of instructions per second, we have already said it can be expected to roughly double every, let's say, 2 years. Memory capacity, which is how many gigabytes of memory can we have in the same size module, is also doubling every 2 years. But memory latency, that is, how long does it take to do a memory operation, has only been improving about 1.1 times every 2 years. So over time, as years go by, if we plot the speed of processors and memory, we get something like this, an exponential curve for the processors, and we get another exponential curve, but that grows a lot slower for memories. This here is the gap between processor performance and memory performance at some time, and then several years later, we have a much wider gap. This problem is often called the memory wall. Basically, our processors are getting a lot faster than memories are, yet they have to access memory every so many instructions. And because this difference in speed has been growing very quickly over many years, we have been using caches as a sort of stairs for the memory wall. So our processors now are accessing caches, which are fast, and only those rare accesses that miss in the cache will end up going to the slow main memory. We will spend several lessons talking about how to do caches and so on, but this is just one of the trends that we have to worry about when we design processors, is that they do get faster, but if the memory doesn't get faster as quickly as they do, we have to continuously keep improving our caches just to allow the processors to not suffer from the much, much slower memory.